choice what happened in Vrindavan or what happened when you came back from Vrindavan. Okay, so now today is either in Vrindavan or on the, how, how on the way to Vrindavan.
On the way to Vrindavan.
Yeah, so all those who want to know on the way to Vrindavan, raise your hand. One, two. What is that from?
I'm sorry, I just sat down.
Yeah, someone do it, I found the name first. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Okay, here the side who's voting for going to Vrindavan. 14, 15, 16, 17. Okay, and what happened in Vrindavan? Who's voting for that one? 1, 2, 3, 4. What's you? What is that? 5. What's 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. It's pretty big margin. Looks like it's on the way to Vrindavan. I'll try to squeeze as much in Vrindavan as you can. So, because they all came from, they didn't know each other until they got to Vrindavan. Really, so much. Narottam Das Thakur, he was crown prince of the capital of Khetri. But he was inclined only to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's service. In fact, when Lord Chaitanya returned from Jagannath Puri and was in Ramakili, he looked out at, looked towards Khetri and he called out, Narottama! 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 And nobody knew what he calling for. They thought maybe some other ecstasy for Krishna. But it was his so much love he has for this Narottama. He had left some special mercy package. When Lord Chaitanya bathed in the Padma River, he left love for Godhead for Narottama. And he told the Padma River to give love of Krishna to Narottama when he came into her waters. So she said, well, how am I going to recognize him? So many people bathe in their waters every day. So when he bathes, you're going to feel ecstasy. And he'll be chanting the names of Krishna and Govardhana. So, when Narottam went to bathe in the Ganges and the Padma, he was a youth. Apparently he was born with a little bit of a dark complexion. When he got to the river and took his bath, then the Padma felt ecstasy. He is chanting Krishna Krishna Hare Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Gauranga Gauranga. And all this must be Narottam. So she gave him love for Krishna package. And it completely, totally transformed him. He became also wore the color of Gauranga. And he was filled with love of Krishna. When he came back home, the guards at the palace didn't want to let him in. Who is this guy? is in Narottam. He cannot lose the rank. You know. Even his mother can recognize him at first. And then when he said, no, it's me, but this thing happened to me in Burma. Oh yeah, sure, just two totally different colors. So he told he wasn't interested after that, was really after that, he's completely in love with Krishna, always talking about Krishna, chanting Hare Krishna. So he told that he's not interested in the throne. He wants to go to Vrindavan. He wants really to join Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He wants to go to Vrindavan and study there under Jiva Goswami. So he navigated from the throne, and his uncle's son became the next heir to the throne. So like this, the Narottam got to Vrindavan. There he was being taught by Jiva Goswami. Jiva Goswami was his Shiksha Guru. He didn't have a Diksha Guru yet. Then he wanted to take Diksha. He was actually very inspired by Lokanathas Goswami. Lokanath Goswami had taken a vow that he wouldn't give anybody initiation. So then Narottam, anyway, since I don't get initiated, but at least I can serve him. So he'd go, every time he would go in the morning, take his shower, and go to the toilet. Narottam would come clean up the whole ashram, sweep it out, clean it. And he'd go into the fields, find where in the forest where he had passed. And clean that up with cow dung. He was doing this for 3 years, very selfless service. And even Lokanath Goswami wasn't sure who was doing this, so he had to hide and see who was doing it. But he saw how it was Narottam, who, even though he told them, he's not going to give him initiation, he's still just serving. So then he started to consider that actually he's a very sincere soul. Krishna will be less pleased if I don't give him initiation than if I break my vow and give him. That if a sincere soul is coming for shelter, we shouldn't refuse something. The whole point of doing a vow is to please Krishna, so it would be counterproductive. So then he told Narottam, okay, you defeated me. And he agreed to give him initiation. So that was how Narottam got his spiritual master, got to Vrindavan. Then there's Srinivasacharya. You'll get all two seats. And that's really traumatic. Srinivasacharya, he was interesting pastime, see? His mother and father were devotees of Lord Chaitanya. Didn't have any children for a long time. So they're all getting older. That's exactly how old we were at the time. One day the wife told, the wife's name was Lakshmi Priya. She told the father of Srinivas that his name was Chaitanya Das. But she felt that Krishna wanted them to have a child. And he was already thinking it's about time for Vanaprasth. She was a bit shocked. She said, what are you thinking about? I know you may think it as just some kind of, lust or mature desire or something, but it's not like that. I really feel this is Krishna's desire. But he wasn't accepting it so easily. Then they agreed, okay, we'll go and see Lord Chaitanya in Jagannath Puri. And if Lord Chaitanya agrees, then we'll have a child. And we'll try. So they together made a journey. They're living near Kut. They were living in a place called Jajigram, outside of Katwa. So they journeyed to Jagannath Puri, 500 kilometers, nice walk. Those days, no train, no more cars. You want to go somewhere, you walk. You took a boat. Unless you were a king or something, then you went by chariots or horses. Ordinary people walked. So it must take about almost a month to walk to Jagannath Puri. So they finally could see that Jagannath Puri temple. Even today when you cross Jagannath Puri, there's a place outside the city as you're driving up. You can see the Puri temple from a distance. Anyone seen the temple like that from a distance? Sadhana, see. Anyone else? Usually when I see it, it's daytime, I can see it from there. I always get out and pay my obeisances right from there. Very moving, the Lord Chaitanya used to do. So then you get into, there's a big road between the Jagannath Puri temple and Gundicha. Well, the trunk road nowadays, or the Rathyatra road. So they're very ecstatic, they're on the road and they're walking towards the main gate, the Singhadwara of the Jagannath Puri temple. And as so maybe 100 meters away, and to their surprise, Lord Chaitanya and his associates, they exited from the gate. So seeing Lord Chaitanya, they were overwhelmed in ecstasy. Immediately the two of them paid their obeisances. And Lord Chaitanya walked right up to them, stopped, pointed to them, to his secretary, said, "These are my dear devotees. See, they get a place to stay, get freshened up, and have darshan and prasadam. Darshan of Lord Jagannath." But he went on. There's two people lying down with their face into the dark ground, they're not even looking up. So all the devotees are, "Wow, who are these people? They must really be great devotees. They were." Lord Chaitanya recognizes them even while they're lying there playing with obeisances. You can't see their face. So they got their royal Vaishnava welcome. Everybody, "Who are you?" And Chaitanya Das, Vaishnava Kripa. Saw they had a nice place to stay, got prasadam, got darshan, everything. Then they wanted to have the audience of Lord Chaitanya. So they went to Dashi Mishra's place and they were brought into the darshan room. And Lord Chaitanya came in. They paid their obeisances. When they got out, it wasn't like wasting time. So look at two of you, go back to your village, perform Govardhana Samskara. You'll have a son and give him the name Srinivas. He'll be doing lots of service for me. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Thank you.
I guess the wife was feeling very confirmed. We're both, you know, it was overwhelming mercy. They got so much mercy from Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his mom, Prasad. They were thinking for hours, days, weeks, well, how to present this to Lord Chaitanya, you know, as a sannyasi. It's probably a bit embarrassing for them to try to put the whole thing into words. What's the proper language to use? All the things. Lord Chaitanya gave them very clear instruction. So they stayed for a few days and then they headed back to the house. Srinivas Acharya was born, as far as I remember, the place on, like, you know, the main, it's on the other side of the river, on the Mayapur side, Chakundi, something like that, Chakundi. Because it was always custom for the mother to have the child at the in-law's house, wherever it was nearby, at her parents' house. So they lived in judging them, but he was born in this Chakundi, which also not very far from Katwa. In one of our earlier safaris, we went there. We came down from Kamanga Shalai. We went to Katwa, we went to Chakundi. So then, they tried to bring up, they had a child, they tried to bring him up as quickly as possible, telling him all kinds of pastimes of Lord Chaitanya and Krishna conscious philosophy. And one day, Srinivas asked his father, how did he get the name Chaitanya Das? Because that wasn't his name at birth, he had another name at birth. So, Nangopodhyaya. So how did they get the name Chaitanya Das? So then his father explained that he had a desire to go to see Lord Chaitanya in Navadvip. So he went from Jachingam towards Navadvip. So on the way he passed through Katwa. And there in Katwa he saw the big crowds of people. And he said, well, what's all the crowds of people for? What's happening? He said, you don't know. Lord Govardhana is here. Govardhana. Yes, Govardhana has come from Navadvip. He's in the ashram. Keshava Bharati. He's going to take sannyas. I was going to go to see Lord Chaitanya Navadvip. He's come here. You don't have to go any further. He's not there anymore. So then he went to the ashram location party, and there were huge crowds of devotees. And Lord Chaitanya was dancing in kirtan. Ecstatic dancing, tears were pouring from his eyes like coming out like syringe water. getting wet from his ecstatic tears. He was there with Nityananda Prabhu and with Chandrasekhar, Gadadhar, and Mukunda. I think that's all. Five and 12. Maybe one more. Five plus one or five. So then, somehow, Chaitanya Das, he got to the front row in the huge crowd. By his good fortune, he was like watching this whole kirtan and everything. And Lord Chaitanya, he said that, listen, he stopped the kirtan. And he said, follow Barbara. I had to shave off now. Said, beautiful flowing hair. So they brought this special barber. Forget his name though. It was the best barber in Katwa. So he said, okay, shave off all my hair. I'll take sannyas. So the barber went to start cutting, and all the people looking like, oh no, cut that beautiful hair, take some gas. The people were just gasping, no, 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 don't do it, don't do it. And then the barber, he freaked out, he said, no, I'm not doing it. I can't do it. So I can't do it. Why? It would be offensive. I mean, you're such a great, saintly person. How can I catch you? Look at it. I tell you, I take all responsibility if there's any offense. But you're a barber. It's your job to cut people's hair. I'm telling you to cut my hair. If you don't do it, you're disobeying a brahmana. Do you want to take that offense? It's like, I mean, there's extreme pressure what to do then. I take all the responsibility, simply doing your duty. There'll be no bad reaction, I guarantee you, you'll get all the good fortune. It's okay. So then when he grabbed Lord Chaitanya's hair, he grabbed this and he's trying to shave the hair, he's getting ecstatic symptoms. His hands are shaking. I said, never, you're never going to have a shaking hand. You're going to cut the person's hair. Tears are pouring from his eyes. And the people are all screaming, no, no! They're pulling their own hair out. They're rolling in the ground again. Ladies are crying. Men are crying. And he's trying to, in the midst, it's like the most emotional situation he's ever found himself in. He's like completely, and I was trying to just get it together to cut Lord Chaitanya's hair. So somehow with very great care and concentration, in the midst of all this ecstasy, tears, shouts, crying, everything, said he cut the hair of Lord Chaitanya off, and the hair was laying on the ground. After he completed the service, he fell on the ground on top of the hair and he was paying his obeisances to Lord Chaitanya. Praying. There's this picture in Katwa. If you ever go there, by the tree under which the five Prabhu, the five of them had, were seated, it's called Bistravatala, resting tree. There's a little bulletin board hanging around there. Bulletin board with a picture inside. As an artist who drew this painting of Lord Chaitanya, freshly shaved, the hair on the ground by his side, he seated, the barber collapsed on top of the hair, in a pool of tears from love. People all looking completely traumatic, pulling their own heads, pulling their own hair, because of the, they don't want to see Lord Chaitanya shaving his hair off and going through these austerities. Huge crowd of men in the back, women. Revelation, if you want to make a painting. Get the idea. And he said, this barber is so special, actually. They say, this is one service in his life. So the rest of his life, he can never stop chanting Hare Krishna. He never cut anybody else's hair. And he just became considered as the greatest saint. And his body is putting samadhi next to the samadhi of the hair of Lord Chaitanya. When he died, he wasn't cremated, he was put in. How many people have touched Lord Chaitanya? The whole little like focus on this one personality. It somehow moved me. It's how everybody that does some service for the Lord is very, very special. Sitting there while the poor barber is like devastated and had some love of Krishna. And Lord Chaitanya gets up and then he says, okay, I'm going to bathe in the Ganges and then come back. So he went to the nearby Ganga, took his bath, all the hair and everything, took it back, came back all fresh, put on the sannyas, he got the sannyas robes from Keshav Bharati, put them on. Then he asked the Keshav Bharati, which mantra are you going to give me? Are you going to give me the Vaishnava sannyas mantra? This one? Then he said the mantra in the ear of Keshav Bharati. So he initiated Keshav Bharati, actually, gave him the mantra. And then Keshav Bharati, okay, so then I'll give you that. Then gave him that mantra. Then he said, your name is Sri Krishna Chaitanya. So all this is happening and Srinivasacharya's father, he is like in the front row watching this whole thing happen. And when he hears, you know, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, it's just like, wow, you know, just like, he just went into like a trance and said, the next 2-3 months, that's all he spoke. To talk in his Sri Krishna Chaitanya. Shri Krishna Chaitanya. Shri Krishna Chaitanya. Shri Krishna Chaitanya. He was just like in total ecstasy. Wow, what did I just see? What happened? What did I experience? And so people start calling this thing, say, oh, he's Chaitanya Das. He's like, what would you like in the supermarket today? Shri Krishna Chaitanya. Bring it home. We live in a supermarket. The super bazaar. So, anyway, the marketplace. So while he's telling this history to his son, and he remembers what happened, and he starts saying, Shri Krishna Chaitanya, he again went in a trance. He fell off his seat, lying on the ground, and again he starts crying in separation of what. And he's saying, Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Shri Krishna Chaitanya. And there he's lying in a pool of tears. And Shri Ras is hearing this whole pastime for the first time and seeing his father next to him. He goes and grabs his father's feet, puts them on his hip, and he starts to cry, Shri Krishna Chaitanya! Shri Krishna Chaitanya!
Shri Krishna Chaitanya!
Shri Krishna Chaitanya!
Shri Krishna Chaitanya!
Shri Krishna Chaitanya!
Shri Krishna Chaitanya!
she's crying. So the wife is in the kitchen cooking, you know, and she goes, what's happened? You know, here's this problem, you know. She hears what she's telling her. Uh-oh, what happened? She comes running into the other room and then sees husband, you know, lying down, crying. Shri Krishna Chaitanya, the son holding the feet of his father, crying. Shri Krishna Chaitanya, what does she do? She pays obeisances. Shri Krishna Chaitanya!
Shri Krishna
Chaitanya!
Shri Krishna Chaitanya!
That was their household life. I'm talking this morning about ideal household life. Everybody could be crying for Lord Chaitanya all the time. So like this, I knew Srinivas grew to be a young man. And he was eager to go to see Lord Chaitanya. He thought since Lord Chaitanya gave him the blessing to be born, to get initiated by Lord Chaitanya, which to firstly teach him the Bhagavatam. He had all these aspirations, hopes and dreams. So taking the blessing from his parents, and he went off to Jagannath Puri in order to get the mercy from Lord Chaitanya. And again, it takes a month, and we walk pretty fast. And then, but it's interesting the scripture in the Bhakti Ratnakara. It says when he was like walking by in Bengal, people, you know, people sit around, I don't know if they didn't have tea stalls in those days, but maybe they sat around a milk stall or something. And had milk and sundaes. Tea was bought by the British, thanks to the British. So they were observing, you know, and they said, who's this really, you know, attractive young man? So they said, maybe he's, you know, some kind of a royal family. Looks very aristocratic, very, you know, fine features. Another one said, maybe he's a deva for some heavenly planet. I don't see people like that. And the third one said, but look at, what's his mouth saying? There's tears in his eyes. You see, he's chanting Hare Krishna. He's one of those associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Gauranga!
So people get recognized. He was a very special person, very handsome, very beautiful, very attractive. So finally he got down to Jagannath Puri. And this, of course, this is the beginning of a very traumatic story. That he got to Jagannath Puri, and there was a big festival going on. And he said, what's happening? Oh, you don't know. Lord Chaitanya has passed away, and he's disappeared. And in the Jagannath Puri temple, and he didn't come back. They opened the door, he wasn't there, he's gone. His pastimes are over, went back to Godhead. And he asked several people, somebody told him he went into Tota Gopina, somebody said he went into the ocean, but anyone confirmed he's gone. So he was devastated. How am I going to learn the Bhagavatam? Who's going to teach me? What's the use of my living if I can't? I failed to get the association of Lord Chaitanya with it. When a man is pounding his head on a tree, he's rolling in the ground, pulling his hair, Lord Chaitanya appears to him in like a vision, like a dream. He thinks I just commit suicide. I don't have any right to commit suicide. I'm here to do my service. You go to see Gadadhar Pandit, he'll help you. And learn the Bhagavatam from him. So, at that time, Gadadhar Pandit wasn't seeing anybody in Rishi Chaitanya, just like the world was also completely overwhelmed in separation. But when he heard the name Srinivas, he looked at him. Because it was well known that there was a Srinivas who was going to carry on the movement of Rishi Chaitanya after he left. So he was very happy to see actually Srinivas. Srinivas paid his obeisance. Please teach me the rabbit to accept me as your disciple. What Chaitanya told me would help me in my journey came to me. So I'm normally not seeing anybody now, but you are very dear to Lord Chaitanya, so I'm seeing you. I'd be happy to teach you the Bhagavatam, but the problem is that look at our Bhagavatam. And he showed their palm leaf Bhagavatam. Those days there were no printing presses, handwritten on leaves, scrolls, just leaves. Then he saw that the Bhagavatam was washed. He said, when we read the Bhagavatam, the pastimes are so beautiful that we cry and the tear, the ink was not permanent ink, it was water soluble. So it was wiped out the pages on the Bhagavatam. So it was illegible. So you had to go to Navadvip and get someone to write a new Bhagavatam and then bring it here and then we can study. So then Srinivas taking the blessings from Gadadhar Prabhu and he went back, walked all the way back to Navadvip on the month and had some garments to write. The way they get a Bhagavatam copy, they delayed it. Like the copies, I don't know how many Brahmins he hired or how he got the money, but somehow he got it done. God gives the Bhagavatam 18,000 verses. Must have been a significant box. And then carried it back to Jagannath Puri. I don't know exactly how long this whole operation took. But by the time he got back to Jagannath Puri, when he reached there at the Tota Gopinath temple, there was a big festival going on. So what's happened? You don't know. Yesterday Gadadhar Prabhu departed. So again he was like totally devastated. Just like so difficult. Don't believe it. If you ask everybody, it's the most true, huh? This is Samadhi. Again, he was like practically out of himself, mad at in separation. How am I going to learn the Bhagavatam? Who's going to teach me? Where do I go now? Lord Chaitanya said he would help. He fainted and Gadadhar Prabhu said, told him to go back to Jagannath Puri, and go back to Navadvipa, and there he would be helped by Then he walked back to Navadvipa, and when he got there, then he found that the people were supposed to pay him, and he remembered that all they left. Again, he collapsed on the ground, and he was revived by one devotee. Said, "Are you Srinivas?" He said, "Yes, I'm Ishan. I'm personal assistant secretary of Vishnu Priya. She wants to see you." So he was Vati for Vishnupriya. Vishnupriya also wasn't singing anybody. She would chant one round and put one rice grain. She just eat that much rice. She became very much very thin. Wasn't taking care of herself. But although she wasn't eating, she still. Srinivasa never saw anybody so beautiful as her, even though she was unkempt and wasn't combing her hair or anything. You could see she was the most beautiful person she'd ever seen. So he paid his prostrate obeisances to her. And then she told him that last night Lord Govardhana came to me. Kept me by his side and on his lap and told me that one of his devotees was very dear but was suffering lots of trauma. Srinivas will be coming here and I should direct him to go to Vrindavan. And there he can get the mercy of Rupa and Sanatana. So, Srinivas Acharya thought that while he's in Navadvipa, better to get this time with some mercy. So he met whatever associates were there, and then he also, Ishana took him on a Navadvipa parikrama, which is recorded in the Bhakti Ratnakara. This is very important because there are not too many Navadvipa parikramas mentioned from that era. We have only Vityananda taking Jiva Goswami, and we have Ishan taking Srinivasacharya mainly. So it mentions all the nine islands and it mentions most of the important places. That's an important report parikrama. And after going on this parikrama, then he had this profound understanding of how Lord Chaitanya was Krishna himself. At the same time, he saw he lived in such a simple environment. He was living in Sachimata's house, was a grass hut. How the Lord of the universe is living in a grass hut. It's like, you'd expect somebody opulent facility, but he lives so simply. She was lying there in the courtyard, outside in the open courtyard in the grandstand. They couldn't sleep. Just looking around, just wondering, how is it that the Lord lived like this? That simple. And then in the middle of the night, he kind of dozed off. And Lord Chaitanya appeared to him and picked him up and flew with him in the air. Took him very high up. And then from the sky, Srinivas could see a wholly different vision of Navadvipa. Effulgent, spiritual abode with a central city with a golden wall, with so many palatial buildings. In the center there was a very large building with a kind of a cloth shape dome, the canopy kind of a dome. And inside there was thousands and thousands of people, people all different kinds of races and people from different countries. Never seen all these different kinds of people. And there on the raised platform there was not the deity of the Panchatattva, but actually the Panchatattva in the living form, accepting worship from associates, and in front of all these devotees are dancing and chanting and ecstasy. Seeing this is like he was overwhelmed. He woke up and looked around, he's back in the courtyard. What did I just see? And he went to sleep again. Again Lord Chaitanya took him up. Again he went into the temple. This time he saw Lord Chaitanya, Vishnu Priya, Lakshmi Priya being worshipped. Woke up again. He had seven visions. Vaikuntha, Goloka, Maheshta. So this also, these visions are inspiration for Mayapur temple, Vedic understanding, Vedic planetarium. It's interesting also that they designed a new design that they're contemplating. I don't know what person keeps the ladies when I heard about it. Something like a canopy. Like a stainless steel cloth. So that also happened while he was on his way to Vrindavan. And finally getting all blessings from some associates, he went on. Vrindavan is quite long, it's about 1400 kilometers. You can get overnight to Jagannath Puri from Calcutta, but to go to Delhi, Vrindavan takes 24 hours. On the Calcutta mail, if you go too far express, you never know when you're going to reach. But Rajgan needs to drive 17 hours. But it's a long way. In those days, walking by the side of the Ganges, it's a good take. I don't know how long it will take months and months to get there. 3-4 months. So finally, he reached Vrindavan. He was at the Akura Kudna. And there he was taking his bath. And he overheard two people walking by saying, you know, Vrindavan is just not the same. His friend said, yes. Without Rupa and Sanatana, it just feels empty. So, what did he say? What? He jumped out on the water and ran up to him. What are you saying? Without Rupa and Sanatana? Why are Rupa Sanatana? You don't know, yesterday they left this world.
Oh no!
You can't be serious. You go to the Rana Govinda temple, you'll see there's a festival going on now for their disappearance. They were just put in samadhi. So then he ran to the Rana Govinda temple, and there was a sure enough a big festival. And the people said, yeah, they left. He was just devastated. He fell on the back of the temple unconscious. Somebody woke him up, said, you, Srinivas, come with me. He picked him up and brought him, and then he was identified, and I am Sri Jiva Goswami, Rupa and Samantha told me in a dream last night that you were coming, that I should take care of you. I should be your Siksha Guru, and Gopal Bhakta Goswami should be your Diksha Guru. So finally he got shelter and Siksha and Diksha Guru. Got to the ground. Then he was born in a Vaishnava family, but they gave him the name Dukhi Krishna Das. Dukhi Krishna Das. So he asked for shelter from Gauridas, Pandit's disciple, Hriday Ananda, Hriday Chaitanya Das. And he said, why this name, Dukhi Krishna? Krishna Das means servants of Krishna are Sukhi. They're happy. So he gave him the name Sukhi Krishna Das. So now you are Sukhi Krishna Das. Happy Krishna Das. You like that name? Then the fame of Jiva Goswami as a great instructor in Krishna consciousness was really well known. So he thought that better I sent Shamana Pandit to learn Vaishnava Tattva Shastra from Jiva Goswami. So he wrote a letter saying, I'm sending to you, you'll be his Siksha Guru. Please instruct him and send him back. And he was sent to Vrindavan, and then he took instructions from Jiva Goswami. So this is how the three of them got to Vrindavan, in short. Any questions? Let's see if there was anything down
there. How did we get from Sukhi Krishna Das?
Kendri is on the other side of, it's on the Indian Bangladesh border, this side of the, it's on the Padma River. There's a city called Rajshahi. It's next to Malda in Bengal, where Ramakalia is situated. And there's some catering.
But at that time, how
was one time the Bangladesh police arrested him and searched him and found a ruby. Said, you're a
spy.
Spy, illegally you entered the country, that he had left his passport in Dhaka for getting a ticket or a visa or something. He didn't have his passport. It was right on the border, and he was kept in jail until they could get his passport out there and get him free. That's quite a traumatic survival. Poor survival. Such a pure soul.
How was he a king when there was
when the emperors, whenever the Mughals were attacking, the kings had an option of surrendering and accepting the emperor, like the Rajasuya. And then they were kept as kings, but subordinate to the emperor. Then they would have to pay every year so much taxes and so many soldiers. It would be a quota that this many soldiers they had to give every year for the empire's army. So that way the empire always stayed on top. Yes?
Could you please tell me how old he was when he left his body? When he...
I don't remember offhand. I'm thinking, I mean, if I get blessings from Vaishnavas, like I've been in the soup, I was thinking of to write an encyclopedia.
Please.
Then you can find all. You can find what year, what day he was born, when he left. And, I'm not a walking encyclopedia. I'm never good for the first thing. I miss it. That's right, this past time, once it was told to me, I heard that Nityananda and Advaita were told to take shelter, and I heard Advaita lived for another 50 years after. So even though it doesn't make sense to me, that's why I don't know. Or 25 years after. 50 years before, then 50 during, and 25. That would be 125 years plus.
He was younger.
He was younger than the others because he was the nephew of Rupan Sanatan. Rupan Sanatan had another brother called Anupam. And Sriji was the son of Anupam. And when Lord Chaitanya visited Ramakili, then Sriji was a crawler, a baby crawling, and he was Lord Chaitanya. And then so he was getting the real nectar, the nectar from the lotus feet. And I would be like, your baby is something Lord Chaitanya's lotus feet. So we've rebuilt the birthplace of Jiva Goswami at Ramakili, a temple there with the deity of Lord Brahma. So that means when Lord Chaitanya went to Ramakili 10 years after he took sannyas. After he came back from South India. So, or almost 10 years. So you can figure out the birth, but it's around how old he was. I have to look it up. Something like that. Why?
When he was born. And
when Lord Chaitanya...
Yeah, I'm mixing two.
You're mixing two up. Yeah, you're mixing Sri Jiva and Sri Jiva.
Yeah.
What was the reason that Lord Chaitanya?
His desire for a guru was so strong. He got a lot of blessing to meet and a lot of associates. Sometimes to get shelter of Guru and Krishna, you have to go through. It didn't come easy for him.
Is it mentioned what happened to the Bhagavatam? That he brought it back to Puri. Then he discovered that.
He took it to Vrindavan, wasn't it?
So he went all the way with him to Vrindavan.
Oh, yeah, he kept that with him.
So that they kept it.
So it means for him to get extra mercy by all the.
Definitely, he got so much mercy. He could see Gadadhar, he could see Vishnupriya, he could see so many associates in Navadvipa. He could see the visions of the Navadvipa Dham and Navadvipa Parikrama. And finally, to get to Vrindavan and get the shelter of Jiva Goswami. But his life is filled with tests. This is just the beginning. When he was taking the books back to Bengal, he learned how to surrender to Krishna to watch the time. Sometimes we get the mercy so easily of Guru, Krishna. We should take it as a special mercy.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.